সাউন্ডটা কমান, সাউন্ডটা কমান। আপনি সাউন্ডটাকে জিরো করে দিন।
Today's topic, Google Tools for Teachers. Our speaker, Dr. Ajay Kumar Sapar. Now we are going to be Ajay Kumar Sapar.
Hello, good morning to all of you. Before starting my session, I am requesting all the participants to please keep your audio and video mute so that we can run the session smoothly. And before starting the session, I would like to thank to the organizer of this webinar, Dr. Nimai Chand Saha, acting librarian, University Librarian Vishwabharati, and also the host of this webinar, Dr. Tapas Kumar Das and Dr. Sanat Bhattacharya, for giving me such an opportunity for delivering the lectures. Today we will be discussing on the Google tool for teachers that will be helpful in the teaching and learning process throughout our academic. So roughly we can say So this topic will be not a very new concept, even most of the participants. Tapas, voice is echoing. This topic will be, as I told you, that most of the participants already know about this, but I have just dragged out some important facts and figure which will be helpful to you. And if time permit, I will show you the some important tools, techniques for these tools available in the Google platform. So first of all, we should know, as we are talking about the Google tool, so first we definitely should know about the Google. So Google is an American multinational technology company that specializes in internet related services and products, which include online advertising technology, a search engine, cloud computing software, that is Android mobile operating system, smartwatch, IoT enabled smart devices, etc., and some of the hardware like Nexus One, Chromebook, Google Wi-Fi, etc. It is considered as one of the big four technological companies alongside the Google, Apple, and Microsoft. Google was founded in the September 1998 by Laurie Page and Sergey Brin while they were doing PhD at the Stanford University in California. It's a headquarter in Mount View, California, and its head office name is the Googleplex. Sundar Pichai is the CEO of Google since 2015, replacing the Laurie Page, who became the CEO of Alphabet. The Alphabet actually is. So now the Laurie Page is the CEO of Alphabet, and since the 2015, Google CEO is Sundar Pichai. Google.com is the most visited website in the world. Several other Google services also comes under top 10 most visited website, including the YouTube and the Google Blogger. So as we know, Google services designed for work and productivity. That means Google has different tools, that is Google Doc, Google Sheets, Google Slides, email services like Gmail, scheduling and time management tools, that is Google Calendar, Google Cloud, that is Google Drive, instant messaging and video chat software or tools, that is Google Duo, Google Hangout, and Google Meet. Language translation tool also, that is Google Translate. Mapping and navigation tools, that is Google Map, Google Waze, Google Earth, Street View, etc. Video sharing tools is also available in the Google, like YouTube. And note taking tools, that is Google Keep, Google Jamboard, and photo organizing and editing tools, that is Google Photos. Google has also some retired many offerings. That means every year or the every time Google is just evaluating their tools and services which is not useful for the common user, they are just retiring that tools. So Google term these tools and services as Google graveyard. That means the tool are sent to the graveyard. Some of the important tool which have been already sent to the Google graveyard, which we already know. I have chosen some of important tools and which is most familiar also, that is Google Picasa. Earlier we are using Google Picasa for organizing and editing the photo, but now it has been replaced by the Google Photo since 2006. Another tool is the Google Plus. Google Plus is a social networking platform, but it has also been shut down in the April 2019. Google Station service that also allow user to spread Wi-Fi hotspot, it has been shut down in the February 2020. Recently, or even recently, they have decided to close the Google Cloud Print, but still it is at running. But in the December 31st, 2020, the Google Cloud Print will be gone in the graveyard. So it will not be accessed. It will not be accessible after December 2020. So I have taken some snapshot of the Google tools. These are the even we cannot adjust in a single window. We have more than 250 Google tools available. So I have chosen some of the important Google tools which we will discuss here, and we will go through that. So first I will discuss about the Google search. Most of us, we are very much familiar about the Google search, and it is the search engine. If anybody asks anything, and if we are not aware of that, we will not bothering about even that, thinking that the Google is there, we will find this answer on the Google. So Google search is such an important tool on which most of the people is dependent now. So we can say it is a web search engine, and it is also the core product of the Google. It receives over 3 billion search queries per day through its 189 regional level domains and available in 149 languages. Google search, also referred to as Google Web Search or simply Google, is a web search engine developed by Google. It is most used search engine on the World Wide Web across all the platforms. The order of search results written by Google is based in part of the priority rank called page rank. That means what you are searching on the Google, the result they are giving according to the page rank wise. Every time you search, there are thousands, sometimes millions of web pages with the helpful information they are providing. Even before you search, we are not thinking what the Google are doing behind the screen, but Google organize information about the web pages in our search index. The index is like a library, like in the physical library, the library people are organizing books according to the DDC pattern. Same way, the Google is also organizing this information in their web domain, so that it will retrieve very quickly to the users. Even in a fraction of second, Google search algorithm sort through hundreds of billions of web pages in our search index to find the most relevant and even useful result for what you are looking for. To help you to find what you are looking for quickly, Google provide result in many useful format, like they provide with a map, with direction even. If you are searching some looking for a place, they will provide a Google, they will give a result with the Google map, including with the direction from your starting point. If you have on your GPS location, then they will give the direction from your starting point also. Even they will give the result in the images, videos, or stories. Google constantly evolving the new way to present the information to satisfy their users. There is another important tool which we generally overlook, but some may definitely have pointed out that the Google on the Google search homepage, they are providing I am feeling lucky link is there. So what is that? So this is very you can say very important and very tricky things. Actually, Google, what you are searching, suppose you have put a search term Vishwa Bharati in the search term, and you just click on the I feel lucky. The Google will relocate directly to the Google, Vishwa Bharati homepage. Please mute your audio, as because noise is creating. No one can hear. Yeah, please. So the Google directly wrote relocated to the user to Vishwa Bharati homepage event. It will not show the all the result related to the Vishwa Bharati. What they do, Google will pick the first result from the Google search, and it will directly open the Vishwa Bharati homepage. So this is the very the beauty of this Google I am feeling lucky options. Even before you search, Google provide what you are looking. Even the many search, as I told you, the different file format they will provide, like they will provide the PDF file, they will provide the Excel and a PPT file also. So if you go through the advanced search, there are different option even also there. So if time allow, I will go to just hands-on with the some important tools and technique, how you can refine your searches, or you can get the better result through the this Google search. The next tool is the Gmail. Gmail is also very much popular among the all the email users as a data represent on the web, that every five user Gmail user is using the Gmail. It is free email service developed by Google in the year 2004, and Google is providing 15 GB of storage across Gmail, Google Drive, and Google Photos. So 15 GB is not a list space, it is a big space, and even for that you need not to delete a single mail from your Gmail. And you can manage many more things on the Google Drive, even Google Photos also on the cloud storage. As of October 2018, Gmail has over 1.5 billion active users. This is a significant increase from the first million user base announced in 2016. That means through this data, we can show that how the Gmail is increasing its user, and we can say how the Gmail user is increasing. It's a simple answer is it's the simplicity, and they are providing the many more tools and services related to the Gmail. Because for getting many more tools from the Google, you have to have an account with the Gmail account. So Gmail account is the basic criteria for getting many more tools from the Google. So it is available in the 105 languages. Sending email is an excellent ally for communication in educational centers such as the school and the institutes. Even this is also the this you can say this may be also useful in the school and institute for the communication purposes, as because their feature is much more enhanced with the other email services. Its email is customized, fast, economic, and effective communication channel. Even that you can communicate with the student, among the students, teachers, parents, guardian, managers, and others. So before going to the Google Store, or even the when we are discussing about the Google has many more also advanced feature which we generally ignore. So like the we can insert the Google signature in the our mail. We can also forwarded we can also set forwarding mail to the Gmail to the other mail. Some likewise, if you have the multiple emails, like you have the Gmail and you have the Yahoo, and you are frequently using the Yahoo, and you can set your forwarding mail to the Gmail. The mail which you receive on the Gmail account will be automatically forwarded to the Yahoo account. So in that case, you need not to search daily your Gmail account. Your all Gmail will be automatically come on the Yahoo mail, and you will be getting all the mails all the time. So this feature is also available, but many more users are not aware about that. So how we can set the forwarding mail, how we can set the signature. Many times I found the official communication without the signature. So at that time, we have to request it to please send your affiliation or something like that. So better you set your affiliation at the signature option. Now we can discuss about the Google Scholar. It is also an important tool for the research and academic. Even it is also the gift the search result. We can say even if you are looking for any scholarly article or a scholarly document, better you choose Google Scholar rather than the simply Google. And because in the Google you will get the even thousands or even lots of results, which will be a very time consuming to go through or select the proper result. But in the case of Google Scholar, the search result will be very much less, and you will get only the scholarly material here. So better to use the Google Scholar. Google Scholar is a freely accessible web search engine that indexes the full text or metadata of the scholarly literature across an array of publishing formats or the discipline. It is released in the year 2004. The Google Scholar index includes most peer-reviewed online academic journals and books, conference papers, cases, and dissertations, print, preprint, abstract, technical report, and other scholarly literature, including court options and the patents also. Scholar has gained a range of features over the time. In 2006, a citation importing feature was implemented, supporting bibliographic managers such as RefWork, RefMan, EndNote, and BibTeX. Actually, earlier the Google Scholar was not so much popular, but since the 2006, when they have implemented the citation feature in the Google Scholar, it is very much popular since then. And even faculty member can create, or the research scholar can create their profile in the Google Scholar, and they will maintain their scholarly publications there. The Google Scholar, what they will do, the Google Scholar will automatically count the citation of your each and every publication. And as a result, the Google Scholar provide you the H index factor, H index and I index of your profile. So some of the cases, institution may also create their Google Scholar account, or the research scholar or the faculty member can also create their Google Scholar account for regulating and for regular monitoring of their profile, so that who is citing you and who is reading your research paper. And even through this feature, you can also get the related document also. Some you can say that if you have a document on the information literacy and you have indexed there, you will find the related document to the information literacy is also available in the Google Scholar also. So this is the very much enhanced feature of the Google Scholar. Actually, it provide also the metrics to the its user. Metrics means it will provide the top 10 journal in the different discipline of the subject domain. So this the research scholar or the faculty member can decide on which journal they will send their research publication for publishing. So this is also an important feature. It contain about roughly 389 million documents, including articles, citations, and patents, making it the world's largest academic search engine.
ধরো যাক, আমি 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 একটা গোলা উদাহরণ নিচ্ছি ছেলে মেয়েদের জন্য। তোমরা সব
The Google Scholar citation provide a simple way for author, as I told you, to keep track of citation to their article. You can check who is citing your publication graph, citation graph also over the time, and compute several citation metrics. You can also make your profile public so that the other person can also retrieve your profile through this. The next tool is the Google Translate. Google Translate is another important tool of the Google, and because some of the teacher or scholar definitely have the some language problem, and this language problem will be solved by the Google Translate at some extent. At some extent, why I am telling you is because this is not the human translation, so it will translate according to the the machine. Actually, they are using the machine translation, so it will not translate the emotions or something like that. So there may be some difference between the human translation or the machine translation, but at some extent it will be very much helpful. So it is available free of cost, and it is multilingual statistical and neural machine translation service developed by Google in 2006. It can translate text and website from one language to another. It offers a website interface, a mobile app for Android and iOS, and as an application programming interface that help developer build browser extension and software application. If you are looking a website which is not available in the Chinese or your mother tongue language, then it will be difficult to find any information from that website. Suppose you are browsing a Chinese website, you cannot understand anything, but through the help of the Google Translate, their content may be translated into the preferred language of your choice, so that it will be easily understandable, and you can get the your related point here. As of June 2020, Google Translate supports 109 languages at various levels, and as of April 2016, claim over 500 million total users of this Google Translate. with more than 100 billion word translated daily. So you can see how much the people are using this Google Translate tool for their teaching and learning processes. Even we can also use this tool for the learning process like this. So if you are not aware about any languages like the Chinese language, you may translate your English hello. It will be translated to the Chinese language what they will pronounce. Even at the during the time of translation, you can also get the sound of the pronunciation. So you can also learn exact pronunciation of any word in this tool. Google Translate does not translate from one language to another. This is the basic ideology behind the Google Translate. We are getting instant translation from the one language to the another language, but behind the screen, Google is not doing the translation from the one language to another language. What they are doing, they are doing translation first to the English language, then it is the targeted language. So they are doing like that. Even Google Translate can translate multiple forms of text and even media, which include text, speech, text within still or moving images. Especially its function include also the written word the translation. As I told you, this will translate the written word to the text to any foreign language or the desired languages. It is also translate the whole website in your desired language. It can also translate the whole document what you will upload. And their limitation of the online translation is 5,000 words. So this is not the least limitation. You can translate even article also, whole article. Speech translation is also done through this feature and this tool. For most, as I told you, its feature, Google Translate provides the pronunciation and even the dictionary of the listening of the exact word what they are using. So now we are moving to the next tool, that is the Google Book. It is also very much helpful for the teaching and learning process for the researchers and the academics. And because as we already know that the no one library is self-sufficient with the financially point of view. So everyone has their financial crunches. So it is available that every book is available in any library. Or we can say the book prices in the library. So through these Google Books, we can, at some extent, we can handle this. Even those books which are the copyrighted free books, which is available in the Google Book, full preview. And even full text of that book. So depending upon the copyright, they are providing the different types of accessibility. Like they are providing the four type of accessibility: full view, preview, snippet view, or no preview. That means the recently launched book, they will give only the bibliographical information that will not provide it, the preview or the full preview also. So this search, actually this Google Book search the full text of books magazine that Google has scanned, converted to the text using OCR and stored in these digital databases also. So you can see, as of the October 2019, Google celebrated its 15 year of Google Books, and it provide the number of scanned books is more than 40 million titles available on the Google Book. So we definitely use this Google Books for getting the even the copyrighted free books we can get from there. Yeah. Next is the Google Classroom. Nowadays, it is this tool is very much popular because we are running in a very very crucial pandemic situation that is caused by the COVID-19. So most of the universities are using the Google Classroom for organizing their online classes and for their academic activity in the different universities, colleges or schools and also. So Google Classroom is the ultimate online hub for your classroom. It is to publish assignments, create classes, make announcements and organize digital files of your classroom. Rest assured that the information is stored on the Google Classroom is kept secure. It's never sold to the advertiser even. Sometimes we are in doubt that that is our assignment or what the project we are uploading on the Google Classroom may be leaked or maybe somewhere it may be shared to the other thing, but you can rest assured that it will not be shared with the other. Neither your data will be sent to any. Yes, it is. Rest assured that the information you stored on the Google Classroom is kept secure. And no one can share your data with your student, even also without your permission, or even the teacher can share the data with the student. So another benefit of the Google Classroom is that along with every other app on this list is completely free. Even during the online classes, you need not to go to send, if you are looking for sending email, you need not to go to separately open your email. It will be allowed to send your email to, from there also. So even you can also communicate with your student via Gmail without leaving this app. You can also start a conversation with one student or even with the several or with the all students with the same interface also. So this application is very much helpful for taking the online classes during this pandemic situation. Now thus another important tool is the Google Drive. We are already aware about this Google Drive, but what Google Drive can do, we have to be aware about that. So as we know that the Google provide 15 GB of online storage, including to its Gmail or Google Drive and all the features available on the Google platform to its user. It is actually the completely free of charge. It's one of the greatest and most convenient part around this. Because as I already told you that the 15 GB is not the least storage space. So even you are getting on the cloud storage, that means you store there and you go here and there and you, anytime you can get this information from the website, from the Google storage. Simply, it is amazing things happening on the Google Drive. And this will also help us for our collaborative researches. With the help of the Google Drive, you can also store many different file types, including PDF file, audio files, images, Word documents, video, and many more things. As I told you, the most useful aspect of the Google Drive is the ability to collaborate with the other. That means you can share file with the file and folder with your students and allow them to view, download, or even create their own file to a central folder. Google Drive is a very handy way to organize files that you or your people, your parents, and to colleagues can securely access. So this tool is very much important for the collaborative research work. And some, actually I have pointed or noted down some tips for teachers, because most of the research scholar or the teaching community is not aware about that. Even the library professional also not aware about that. The Google Drive is also accessible offline. Our conception is that the Google Drive is only accessible online, but offline Google Drive is also accessible. You have to install that one. Now the Google Doc. The Google Doc is also available free of cost, and this tool is developed by the Google. Is actually often confused with the Google Drive, but this is not the Google Drive, this is the Google Doc. It is just similar with the Microsoft Word, but this Google Doc, the this word processor software is available on the cloud. So here also one can also share the collaborative research work through this tool. So Google Doc is often, as I told you, confused with the Google Drive, but the two are different. While Google Drive is online storage of the digital files, and Google Doc is word processing tool that you can use to create your Word document. It is strikingly similar to Microsoft Word, as I told you that, but this here you will get the add-on features like this. Through this Google Doc, you can see, you can do the collaborative research work, and it is online or the cloud-based. But Microsoft Word is not the cloud-based. It is it should be installed on your computer or laptop. When it comes to the classroom, you can use Google Doc to go paperless. Gone are the day of the dog at my homework. Ask the student to turn in term paper, essay, book report, etc. over the Google Doc. This way you can make notes, edit, and suggestions all from your computer. No need to lug around the stack of papers for going the day. You can also use Google Doc in a collaborative assignments where a group of students work on a writing project together. So this Google Doc can also allow you to work together or the collaborative work. Google Doc comes with a built-in chat and module for real-time teamwork also. The next tool is the Google Meet. Nowadays, it is also very much popular during the COVID-19 pandemic, is because we are not able to sit in a physical, in a confined room for doing a meeting or some seminar or some academic or administrative activity. So Google Meet can be an alternate of that, to which we can arrange the online meeting, online webinar, something like that. So Google is making enterprise grade of video conferencing available to everyone. Now anyone with a Google account can create an online meeting with up to 100 participants and meet for up to the 60 minutes per meeting, up to the 24 hours per meeting in September 30, 2020. It will be increased later on. Google Meet is a video communication service developed by Google. It is one of two applications that constitute the new version of Google Hangout, and the other being the Google Chat. Earlier, the Google Hangout and Google Chat is also available, but through that we cannot able to do the conferencing. So we can communicate with one-to-one through that application. Now it has been merged these two apps and they have created a new version of that application in the Google Meet. With it we can communicate through the face-to-face interactions like the video conferencing. Meet on any device, invited guest can join an online video conference from their computer using any modern web browser. No software is required to install. On mobile device, they can join from the Google Meet app. Even this app is, if you have the Gmail account, this app will be automatically displayed in the left hand panel of your Gmail. I will show you when time permit. I will show you where it is appearing on your Gmail box. So through that, even you can also arrange a webinar or an online meeting with your participants. Google CS Fast is the computer science application designed by the Google. A free computer science curriculum that makes coding easy to teach and fun to learn. Earlier, we have the thought that the person who is efficient in the computer science can teach the computer science subject. But through this tool, you can teach the computer science with the Google CS. Even you are not expert in the computer science. But this application is limited to the age group between the 9 to 14 years of age. Because this is the basic computer science program, so it can be teach in the children of age 9 to 14. It provides teachers with the tools and resources to teach computer science with having no cost. So now every student can have access to a skill that will be shape the future of his or her. So nowadays, computer science profession is very much the job oriented or something like that. Even Google is also launching the Google code for the kids. So you can join with that. Google Science Fair. Google also organizing its own science fair. This online competition is open to students around the globe, age between 13 to 18 years, who formulate a hypothesis, perform an experiment, and present their results. They can join the this Google Science Fair. Even they are providing the three levels of prize distribution. Even their prize money is not listed, a huge prize money they are providing. This Google Science Fair has been first announced in the year 2011. Winners are awarded scholarship funding, even the mentorship, even the educational trip to the foreign also. So all students have must an internet connection and a free Google account to participate this science fair. And the project must be in English or German, Italian, Spanish, or French. The final submission must be included in 10 sections, which are the summary and about me page on the step of the project and the work cited page, something like that. So they have given the criteria on their website, the Google Science Fair. Even for this year, 2020, they have not yet announced the date due to this pandemic situation. So if those who are interested to join this Google Science Fair can have a watch on the Google Science Fair website for regular update. The Google Contacts. Earlier we have the mobile contacts. So we are very much worried when we are changing SIM from one SIM to another SIM, or the we are very much worried when we are changing mobile. So we are generally fetching that mobile contacts to the contact to the another mobile or to the another scene. But with the advent of the Google or with the introduction of the Google contacts, now no need to worry about the your contacts available in your phone or even in your PC. So now you can save all your contacts in the Google contacts. So Google contact is Google contact management tool. Is available in its free email service, Gmail, as a standalone service as a part of Google business oriented suite of the application G Suite. Google contact can be synchronized with mobile device and the operating system. As I told you, you can also sync your all your contact available in your mobile with the Gmail contact, Google contact. And now you need not worry to take all the backups of your phone contact. If you change your mobile and if you log in through your Gmail account, all the contacts saved in your Google account will be available on your another mobile device also. So now you need not to worry about the saving or the taking the backup from the one mobile to the another mobile. The user can choose to import or export the file content outside of the interoperations mode listed above by choosing the More menu item on the most of the Google service web page displaying the contact list. The user can also then choose to use the file as a hard backup. That means Google Contact will provide you the import-export facility also. You can also import all your contact from the mobile device. It can be restored in the Google contact, and even the your all Google contact may be exported to the hard disk in a different file format like CSV or the text format. So later you can also synchronize with the another mobile which you are looking. The next tool is the Google Earth. Google Earth is also very much important tool is providing by the Google, and it is also very much helpful in the teaching and learning process. It is one of the more fascinating tools available in through the Google. Use this app to explore the Earth in 3D. This is especially useful in the case of geography or the social studies, but can even come in handy during history exploration. Take your student on a virtual field trip to the farthest reaches of the globe. Through this application, you can visualize your student any virtual tour of your of the course curriculum. In fact, you can also use this Google Earth in every major discipline, from computing math equations to understanding marine biology also. Download the desktop version of the Google Earth or download the Google Earth plugin to view on the web. You can even access Google Earth through your mobile device also. While it's named Google Earth, you are not bound to just this celestial body when using this immersive tool. Explore the moon, see the face of Mars, or even zoom up close to distant galaxy far away. So you can use this tool in many more areas or in many more ways. So as you like, you can use this tool, especially in the field of geography or the social studies. It is very much helpful. The next tool is the Google Map. Google Map is also very much important, likewise the Google Earth. Here, the chances are you are used Google Maps before. It is most popular mapping tool on the internet that provide driving direction as well as the 360 street view of the location all around the globe. So you can use it in the classroom as a virtual atlas. Pair with Panormio to find stunning images from the use about any location in the world. Google Map is great companion to the geography station because it gives a sense of place to word on a map. Likewise, the Google Earth, it is also very much helpful for the Google geography students because this basically deals with the landscape and even the 360 street view also of any location. So when we are discussing about the Google Map and Google Earth, basic question arises in our mind that what are the basic differences between the Google Map and the Google Earth. So I have pointed out here the Google Map contains all the navigation, lightweight mapping power and point of interest with just a small hint of satellite imagery, while Google Earth has completed 3D satellite data in just a small subset of information on place without any point-to-point navigation. So when we are driving the car, we are also using the Google Map for getting the direction, or even the street view also it will be using in getting any exact location. Nowadays it is also very much helpful for even during the crime scene situation also. So people are sharing their exact location and our police department is just helping in getting the exact location of the crime scene or something like that. The next tool is the YouTube is also very much important for our teaching and learning. Google has this application since 2006. Earlier it was a separate company, but in the year 2006 the Google have procured this YouTube for managing their videos. So YouTube happened to be the internet's second largest search engine, and it's true that you can find just about any answer on this popular video site. However, YouTube is also an educational resource that you should definitely consider for free. High quality video on every topic imaginable, from Einstein's theory of relativity to the migratory pattern of wildebeest, you will find the wealth of information to support your lesson plan. Even what we are organizing day to day during this COVID situation, a lot of webinar is also organizing through this different type of video hosting software. All this video is also uploaded, going to uploaded there on the YouTube. So nowadays you can consider that the most of the thing is available on the Google, or even if you want to just get an hands-on training, the YouTube is very much helpful for that. You can get everything related to study on the Google tool. The next tool is the Google Calendar. It is used to manage or organize your time. So I'm giving you the instant example of that Google Calendar, how it is helpful. So we are organizing this event since 16, and the host is regularly sending us the mail. This mail is automatically saved in our Google Calendar, and my Google Calendar remind me before the day, or you can say before the half an hour, that this program is going to be conducted, so please be ready or something like that, so that you cannot miss any program. So Google is helping in that way. So Google Calendar is the perfect way to organize your time. Use Google Calendar to plan your daily schedule, get reminders, create a day-to-day list, and collaborate with others. if you need to set up a paper parent teacher conference, use Google Calendar to help schedule and confirm so that you cannot miss it out. You can even use Google Calendar for as your lesson planner. Create it and then add the Google Calendar to your classroom or the Google Sites. So now this is the another tool is the Google website. Google is also providing a tool to create your website. That website may be your personal website. That website may be your institutional or corporate website. It's a totally free of cost. Even they are providing a different types of the template. Using that template, you can create your website, and your website will be available on the internet, and anybody can access that. So in addition to the Google Classroom, you may choose to create a website of your classroom. Enter Google Sites. So that the difference between Google Classroom and Google Site access. Google Classroom is geared toward a student-teacher relationship. However, Google Site is open to students, parents, and fellow colleagues. Use a Google Site to quickly set up functional and relatively attractive websites where you can do the following. Post announcements, publish classroom rules, inform of upcoming events, create a wikis for your class project, upload a share file, post reading material, introduce topic or theme for the month, share curriculum resources. That means Google Classroom is it actually the two-way communication. There student and teacher communicate each other, but website is a one-way communication. Through this website, you can post your announcement, and you can also aware about the activity and services of your classes or of your institute or of your college or schools. So this tool is very much also important to publicize yourself or your institute or your about your classes or something like that, so that many more people can aware about your services. The next tool is the Google Cultural Institute. Hardly we have heard about this tool. And because, as I already told you, that Google has a lot of tools and services in its domain, but most of the people are not aware about that services. So here, another way to take a field trip without leaving the classroom, that means through the Google Cultural Institute, we can have a virtual trip. Without leaving the classroom. That means within the classroom, you may show your student the trip of any places, any museum, or something like that to explore their work of art from different types or different period. So Cultural Institute is an excellent additional to the virtual art classes. Use this tool to introduce cultural awareness through art. The next tool is also an important tool, which nowadays is now getting much more popularity or familiarity amongst the user, as because this tool is using the artificial intelligence. That means this experimental tool from Google uses artificial intelligence to turn your rough drawing into polished or recognizable images. Just begin drawing an object to the tool will offer suggestion that you can then choose from. As I have shown in the picture, I have tried to draw a cycle. The Google has detected that what I am trying to draw. And they will give the option of you can say in the picture they are providing the options what you are looking for. Are you drawing a cycle? Then I choose this. Yes, I am drawing two cycles, and they will provide this. That means they are using the artificial intelligence behind the screen. What you are looking, what you are looking to draw. In the second picture, I would like to draw a car. That they automatically detect, oh, that means you are drawing a car. So they have given the option, and I have chosen the car. Change the image color also possible, the size and your orientation and a text before downloading for free. These are so many creative uses for auto draw in the classroom, like creating quick sketch note, infographic and story illustration to the name a few. Auto draw is a new kind of drawing tool. It pairs machine learning with drawing from talented artists to help everyone create anything visual fast. There's nothing to download, nothing to pay for, and it works everywhere, smartphone, tablet, laptop, desktop, and many more applications also. The next tool is the Google Chrome. Google Chrome Music Lab. Actually tool is helpful to create a audio or a video, or you can say the you can also compose a song for your activity. This Music Chrome is a website that makes learning music more accessible through fun hands-on experiment. This tool is very much helpful for the music professionals. The user who are looking or who are learning the music, this tool will be very much helpful for them. This Google experiment allows students to explore music and its connections to science, math, and art. Try various tools within the website to create new rhythm and the sound, study pattern within music, compose song, or just play. Many teachers have been using Chrome Music Lab as a tool in their classroom to explore music and its connection to science, math, art, and many more. They have been combining with it with dance and the live instruments. Anyone can play with these experiments across devices, from tablets, laptop, desktop, just by opening the site on web browser such as Chrome. So this is all about the Google tools. Even we cannot finish in a single day, as I already told you, this much the huge number of Google tools is available on their domain. But I have taken a few of the, them, which is helpful for your teaching and learning processes. So I think time is there, so I can show you two, three hands-on on the some important tips of the Google tools. So I'm just asking from the host whether can I proceed for the hands-on with the some?
Yeah. No problem.
Oh, thanks. So, are you getting my screen, the Gmail screen? Are you getting, Sanada? Okay, thanks. So, I have already created my Gmail, and even I am using since 2006. So, I have just logged in my Gmail account. So, I just want to show you some important tips. What you have, what I have already discussed in my lecture. So, the mail, as I already told you that the Google Meet is implemented in the Google. So here in the left hand pane, you see a start a meeting, join a meeting. This option is already there given. So the Google Meet is already integrated on your Gmail. So yeah, the important option is given here. I can find the question mark sign there. If you click on that, you will get a help, training, or update. If you click on the update, you will find what are the latest updates by the Google. You see in the December 2019, what the update has been given, November month wise, or the on what frequent they are doing the update. You will get the update on your Gmail help option. And even if you want to search anything like the, if you are not aware about the Google Meet, so you may also search Google Meet. And you can have a ready-made material, or you can get the tutorial even also from there, and you will be aware about the Google Meet from there. You can also get the training. You can also if you click on the help, you will get the frequently asked questions on the different aspect, like Gmail message are missing, delete or recover deleted mail, how you can delete, how you can change your password. So all things you will get from there. So hardly people are using this services or this function for updating him or herself. So I even in my lecture I told you that the setting up your signatures. Click on the setting option. You will see the different types of options is already there. So you can also choose the maximum number of mail in a page. You can set how much you are going to set. Even also you can send you can also set the undo. That means what mail you have already been sent, if you want to just revert back, or you later on you have decided, oh, this mail actually I did not want to send that, so you can send the time for undo message. You see here, if you set the time, and within that time, if you want to send the undo, your already sent mail will be just revert back. So this is very new features has been implemented by the Google. So hardly people are aware about that. So just I'm trying to aware of some of the important facts. Even you can also set the grammar suggestions, that what you are typing, if you want, if you have some mistake on writing, the Google grammar can also already inform you that the correct word may be like that. So sometime we are on the vacation, and people are trying to connect us, and even we for a long time we are not able to get our mail. So during that time, we can also set the vacation response mail also. And when anybody will send us mail, they will automatically get us get our vacation response mail that I am on vacation, and after that stipulated time, you can get you back, something like that. In the signature column, you can set your signature here. See. I have already set my signature. So when I communicate or when I write a email, suppose I want to compose a mail, you see here the signature will automatically come. So every time it will not require to write the signature. So it will be automatically already included. So as I already told you, the vacation response through here, you can also set the vacation response. Even you can also set the duration of the period from when to up to when you are going on vacation, and this vacation response will auto reply. And after that duration, you have to respond accordingly, and it will be automatically off. So there are different options are given here. You can also create, like in the left hand pane, there is a inbox, some default already setting, sent mail, draft, even you can also create some according to your choice in the level option. You can also change the inbox different priority. Even you can also filter your mail through some keyword that if a mail is coming with that word, it will be automatically relocating to the some specific folder or label which we had created. You can also import your account also. Here the option is for forwarding mail. You see here I have forwarded this mail to my Vishu Bharati ID. Because sometimes I am not, if I am not able to get this Gmail account, I will be getting all these Gmail account to my Vishu Bharati ID. Someone can also set their institutional mail ID to the Gmail ID or something from the Yahoo to Gmail, which we are looking frequently. We can set and we'll get the mail regularly on the specified mail. So this is all about the Gmail. Even many more feature is still there, but we cannot discuss in a single class. So I am just pointing out some important points. So now I move to the Google search, which is also very much important and very much familiar within us. And people are using Google search for getting anything. You see, we are using, you see here, I have typed Vishwabharti, and I just click on I am feeling lucky. What they will give, you see here, the Vishwabharti website has been automatically opened. Visit our website. If I will put here, Banaras Hindu University. Sorry. Banaras Hindu University. And I click on the I am feeling lucky. See here, the Google search directly opened the Banaras Hindu University website. That means it automatically allow you just to go directly to the first result. Even their homepage of the first result, it has not displayed all the results through the Banaras Hindu University. So this is the beauty of the I am feeling lucky option in the Google search. The next, I am just showing you the some important tips. I am not going to discuss all the tools and the search strategy through the Google. People are using images for the different purposes, like for the preparation of the PPT, preparation of the research paper, people are just or the research scholar or the faculty member is using pictures from the Google. But do we aware about which picture can be used for this purpose, whether that picture is copyright free or not, whether they have some copyright things or not, issue or not. So the Google has the option to get that type of picture which is the copyright free. So they have the option in the advanced version of the Google search. So suppose I want to search. Primary school. So I need to search Google images. They will give the all the images, but we are not sure these images can be used directly by the any users, as because these pictures may not be copyright free. So in the Google search, you search advanced search. The setting they are giving the advanced search. So here you see the usage right. You click here and choose free to use or share. Here you see different type of options they are giving, free to use or share, even commercial also. So free to use, share or modify, free to use, share or modify, even commercial. So just I want to filter this one. You see these pictures are copyrighted free. This can be used for your teaching and academic purposes, and there is no any copyright obligation for that. So hardly people are using this technique for getting the images which are the copyright free. Even you can also refine your search term by getting the image size, even the file type also, image type, which type of image you are looking for, or something like that. Even the file type also, which type of images you are searching. So these are the important features. Now I am moving to the another features. There is another feature in the Google, like if I want to search COVID-19, you will see how much data they have retrieved. Even we cannot count anymore. I think 60 lakh or the 60 crore, something like that. So how we can get the actual data or what we are searching, something like that. So better you search the advanced search rather than the simply Google search. So in the advanced search option, you will be getting your search very in a very refined manner. Like language, which language you are looking for? English language, I am looking for. Region you can also confine. Suppose I am looking for that, for the search result comes for the India. Yeah. Even the updated time, I am looking for a most updated, even up to the week ago, I am looking for that. The file type, I am looking for the PDF only. And copyright here. So now you can advance search. So you see, the result has already shown the PDF document. So now you can refer your document. Even the result has also very much limited, even you can say up to the 4 pages, I think the 100 or the 200. The next option to get the next tool I would like to show you, the Google Scholar. As I already told you, for getting of these services, you have to Google account. Otherwise, these services will not be provided. As you see, as I already login in my Gmail account, my the Google Scholar profile is already showing. So when I click in my profile, you see here my Google Scholar profile is already displayed. How what are the articles I have uploaded in the Google Scholar, and how much time the article has been cited, total citations, even the graph over the time is also displaying. What are the H index I have, and what are the I index of the any faculty or my I index. You can also see all the things. Even you can check whether this if you have done your this IT public, then anybody can search also. Likewise, I like to search some profile has been created by the Vishwa Bharati faculty. You can also search like the R. Siva Kumar, their ID is Google Scholar ID public, and he has received 13,369 citations. The Swapan Datta has 12,381 citations, is also from the Vishwa Bharati. So actually the recognition of any authors depend upon the number of citations. Nowadays it is not required that the quantity of your research production, that means how much your research paper you have been published. But nowadays the date is coming to which our evaluation will be determined on how much you are getting citations. That means it may be the 2 papers in a year, the person who has published 2 papers in a year got 100 citations, but another person who has written the 10 paper but got a single citation is much more academic, have the academic credibility, or the much more renowned who have got the 2 paper with the 100 citations like that. So I am requesting all the teachers and the research scholar to please create your Google Scholar ID, and you put all your research publications there, so that and make it public also, so that the other people can get access and will get ultimately the more citation, and ultimately you get the more recognition. So this is all about the Google tools. I am not going to detail all the tools in detail. If another session in the another series of webinar will be organized, then I will take over the rest part of the Google tool in hands-on. So now I am winding this session here, and thank you for your kind listening. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me there, or you can also. So thank you very much. Thank you.
So if you have any question, please you may ask or write in the chat box also.
Sir, have you any software about the Google CS first? Especially yeah, in
it is already please mute all the other participants. Otherwise, I cannot able to answer. You just open the Google CS. You need to create a Google ID to use login and you will be getting access. All the resources you will get from and you can teach the students.
One question, what are the
differences
between Google Meet and Google Classroom?
Google Meet and Google Classroom. Actually, as I already told you, Google Classroom is essentially for taking online classes where you can keep the assignments, all that activities in your class. You can also provide the assignments, but in the you can organize a video or you can organize the assignments. It is just a difference from Meet to the Google Classroom. Google Classroom is basically online class. People are teaching Google Meet, but this is not the right way to look at the cannot evaluate your assignments, you cannot projects. Yeah. You can only arrange the online meeting in the form of online class. The next question.
So, any question from the participant or more question?
Is it possible to
for information on more informing for Google tools? Thank you, Mr. Sharma.
Sir, I cannot
hear you clearly.
Hello. Have you any question?
I have one. Is it possible to show these to our students later?
Student data.
Then students later. Later to the students when they come or something. Because it would be very useful for them.
I'm sure. Yeah, definitely.
This session is already recording.
Recording once.
So, our recorded video will be uploaded on YouTube channel.
And
we will also share that on YouTube.
All the participants and also students.
Yeah, okay. That would be good. Thank you.
Okay, may I request to all the participants to open your videos to take a photo session of this photograph of this session. Please open your video. Proshanjit Shah, please.
Hello, Ajay da.
Hello.
Can you hear me, Ajay da?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yes, please. If you are not able to ask your question, you can mute your video also. You can send
your question in chat box.
Later I will
verify on your way.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, Ajay Sharma, for your nice and informative deliberation. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.